Hello. First, I'd like to start off saying I'm sorry that we are unable to have our traditional tea party this year with the first and eighth grade buddy classes. It's been a fun tradition that the old first grade teacher years and years ago, I don't even know her name, had started, and it went away for a while after she had left. And so my second year of teaching, I decided to bring it back to kind of regain that tradition. So basically, we have a tea party, and it's going to look very different this year, obviously, since we're going to be just saying hi to each other with our own treats in the car and maybe something to drink. But I thought I would just still tell you guys some tea party etiquette. So, obviously it depends on where you are. Things could change, but these are just some basic rules that I typically teach the first and eighth graders. So the first one is as I'm like doing it right now, as I'm kind of slouched over while I'm talking to this video. So you're supposed to have nice posture. You want your shoulders back, and actually it's healthier for you to have good posture all the time. There's lots of studies that say that having in your back like this is not good for your spine. So we should always try to have good posture all the time. But at the tea party, if we were to have it together, I would make everybody make sure that they're working on their posture. Second thing is sometimes at dinner, we might have our elbows on the table. It's actually a little more proper to have your elbows off the table. So good posture, no elbows on the table. Looks fancier, I suppose. Other thing is you put a napkin on your lap. Obviously, we're not doing that. But if you want to have a tea party at home and do these things, I encourage you to. Another thing is we will be dressing fancy. That's like the one thing that we get to keep this year, that we get to be fancy in our car. next thing is some people like to have their finger up while drinking tea, which is kind of fun. And then another etiquette thing we used to do at the party is the eighth graders would pour the first graders tea. So apparently some people, their tradition is to have somebody else pour their tea for them. So what we would typically do is eighth graders would pour the first graders, and then so the first graders don't burn their hands, we would have the eighth graders pour other eighth graders tea. So I hope that the first graders, when you're in eighth grade, I hope this tradition is still there so you get to experience it. But I encourage you to have a tea party at home with your family and have good posture and elbows off the table, put your pinky up, and have very nice manners, of course, saying yes, please, and no, thank you. So yeah, I hope you have fun to at least be able to see each other in the parking lot. We'll make the best of it.